Hello guys, this is Chris from Coffee Russian. Всем привет, это Крис. And today I want to tell you a difference between two very similar words, из-за and потому что. Из-за and потому что. Both of them mean because. But let's look at them in a sentence. Я осталась дома, потому что... Сегодня холодно. Я осталась дома, потому что сегодня холодно. I stayed home because it's cold today. Or, из-за погоды я осталась дома. Из-за погоды я осталась дома. Because of the weather, I stayed at home. Из-за сильного солнца я сгорела. Я сгорела literally means like I was burnt, but it means I got a sunburn. So, из-за сильного солнца я сгорела. Because of a very strong sun, I got sunburn. So, я сгорела из-за сильного солнца. Or, я сгорела, потому что солнце было очень сильное сегодня. Я сгорела, потому что солнце было очень сильное сегодня. I got sunburn because the sun was very strong today. So, did you catch the difference? When we say из-за, we need to use a noun after it. Only a noun. It's kind of like in English you say because of. And after of, you need to use a noun or a gerund. For example, из-за солнца, because of the sun. Or, из-за погоды, because of the weather. But, when you say потому что, because, here you need to use a sentence. Потому что было холодно, because it was cold. Or, потому что солнце было сильное. Because the sun was very strong. So both of them mean because, but из-за, you need to use only a noun. After потому что, you need to use a sentence. Let's practice your audio skills a little bit more. Я очень устала, потому что у меня было много работы. Я очень устала, потому что у меня было много работы.
I was very tired because I had a lot of work.
Or you can say, из-за работы я очень устала. Из-за работы я очень устала.
Because of work, I was very tired.
Я опоздала, потому что я проспала. Я опоздала, потому что я проспала.
I'm late, or I was late, because I overslept.
Я проспала. I overslept. Из-за пробки я опоздала.
Because of the traffic jam, I'm late.
Из-за пробки, пробка, that's a traffic jam, я опоздала.
So what I recommend you to do now, put the video on pause and make, you know, like 2, 3, 5 pairs of sentences using из-за and потому что. Super useful practice. And when you write down the sentences, pronounce them out loud. That's a very important part of your today's Russian practice, guys. And this video is a part of a little marathon I'm doing to present you guys a meeting, a live 3 hours Russian practice meeting that we are going to have on 28th of November, super soon, and practicing language is the best way to learn it, it's the funniest way to learn it, and you can find some motivation, you can find some friends who are into the same things that you like, and one of them obviously Russian. You can train all the vocabulary and grammar you already learned by going through the textbooks, and you know, if you don't live in a Russian-speaking country, I think that's the best way to learn the language that you're studying and to keep the motivation going. So if you would like to participate, I'm going to prepare different topics for us to discuss, different vocabulary for us to go through, and different grammar constructions to train and make them like a habit of using them. So you can find some information in the description of this video, and we'll be waiting for you guys. Пока-пока!